man. This probably is my favourite music video that I've ever done. And it's in colour. Can you believe that? Still sitting down, just in my own special different way. But in 2019, my friend DeRay took me to go and see an early screening of a film called The Last Black Man in San Francisco. Have any of you guys seen that movie? And it blew me away aesthetically. It was so poetic and moving and such an amazing love letter to San Francisco. And during it, I said to my friend, I was like, whoever directed this, I've got to work with him. I managed to get Joe's email and I just told him how much it moved me and stuff like that. And then 2020 hit. And I actually wasn't sure if I was ever going to put the album out in COVID and stuff like that. And then we went to Palm Springs with our other halves and this was created. So, yeah, I'll tell you more about it afterwards. But thanks for coming, guys. I hope you enjoy it.
We just sit. We hold it. You sing along with. Oh.
I haven't even had any wine yet. Fucking hell.
Got that out of the way.
Is it going to come on? Oh, thank you. You all look so pretty. Happy birthday. Here we go. Look, it started. Here we go.
How can one become so bounded by choices that somebody else made? How come we've both become a version of a person we don't even like? We're in love with the world, but the world just wants to bring us down by putting ideas in our heads that corrupt our hearts somehow. When I was a child, every single thing could blow my mind, soaking it all up for fun, but now I only soak up wine. They say to play hard, you work hard, find balance in the sacrifice, yet I don't know anybody's truly satisfied. You better believe I'm trying to keep climbing, but the higher we climb feels like we're both none the wiser. So I hope I learn to get over myself, stop trying to be somebody else, so we can love each other for free. Everybody wants something, you just want me. Why am I obsessing about the things I can't control? Why am I seeking approval from people I don't even know? In these crazy times, I hope to find something I can cling on to. 'Cause I need some substance in my life, something real, something that feels true. You better believe for you I've cried. Oh. to keep climbing, but the higher we climb feels like we're both none the wiser.
I wish that it was just at a different time. A most turbulent period of my life. Why would I put that on you? That's just like a very heavy thing to have to talk about. But because of that period of time, even though it was so much fun, I didn't get to go on and make new memories with him. There was just memories in a big storm.
I drink wine, everyone go crazy. That was insane. Do you ever sing and you catch yourself and you're like, oh my God, that sounded so good?
No, not really.
Adele.
I mean, I definitely am like, yes, I reached the note.
Yeah, you're like, okay,
yeah,
that's
definitely
it.
Like, I reached,
but you're never
it,
just
yeah.
singing in the car and you're like, holy shit, that
no.
was really good.
There was one time when I was about 15 and I was like practicing like some runs and I was like, oh, yeah. I got that one.
You're but like, no, there
not,
we go.
Not really, yeah. Not, yeah. Not really since I actually became a singer, no.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Something to think about. What did we think of the video, everyone? Okay, so you made it with Joe Talbot.
I did.
Can you talk about that collaboration, how it started? You talked a little bit about...
Well, yeah, I saw the movie. I saw his debut movie, and I just absolutely loved it, and I managed to get his email, and that was it, really. I was just gushing.
Well, that you managed. I'm like, Adele, I think you can get his email. They're like, yeah, no, absolutely.
But also, you know, it was coming out. He was busy and stuff like that. And also, you know, he's very cool, Joe. So I didn't know if he was going to be a bit too cool to want to, like, be associated with me. Anyway, I mean, I know I'm cool, but not out there in the world. You know, I mean, I wouldn't say I'm a cool, but I'm a very cool person in real life.
No, I know, baby.
No, you know what I mean, you know what I mean.
I know.
You know, he's very brilliant. Anyway, and then... When it was time to sort of start doing the video and stuff like that, I said to my manager, I want to ask Joe Talbot and stuff like that. And then we chatted for a while and then we went away. I have a house in Palm Springs. So him and his partner and me and my partner, we went up there and we just sort of reminisced about our lives and we're the same age and stuff like that. And this sort of fantasy world and the cheekiness and all of it that we wanted and stuff like that. And then he came back with that treatment after the trip and I loved it.
I love it too. Yeah. The lazy river.
Yes.
I grew up in Idaho and there's like a water park and there it's like that. So you could have shot it there.
Well,
babe.
Also.
Literally. I know you shot at Paramount. I saw it.
Well, in 2019, I went to Idaho. My girlfriend has a house there.
Oh my God.
And I went tubing. You know, went tubing on the lazy river, and it was my first time. And I can't believe that that's an American thing that you just do.
Oh yeah,
for fun.
We like, all did it know. Today. Yeah,
and so I got in a tube. I got in a tube and fully clothed. You know,
of course,
a little bit like in the video. And I went down Abbey Wine. You know, Abbey Phone and all of that. Luckily, it wasn't. There were no rapids or anything like that. I got stuck a lot, but it was really really amazing.
You
were
like in the rapids.
It was really. Yeah. I felt very free. Like, and you know, in the summer of 2019, I was trying to make myself feel tiny, and I thought I had to go up high for those things. So I got into hiking and like trying to climb mountains and shit like that. Yeah. And I realized actually I had to get low and to feel tiny. Water really became something for me. So me going tubing and like jumping in the middle of a lake in Idaho while the boat was moving, and like they didn't realize for about 10 minutes that I jumped off.
Oh God.
Yeah, and I was just like floating.
Just
there was
Adele
no salt in
the
there's no salt in the water, so I was fucking sinking.
Bye Adele. The boat's like, so cool.
I also jumped in a sweatsuit. Which
can't wait for the album.
But yeah, anyway, so it was so, and he didn't know that. It was so random when he gave me the treatment. And I sent you the picture, didn't I, Joe, of me in it, just like living my best life. Just,
oh,
like,
Joe's here.
Out.
Everybody,
yeah,
let's
Joe's
give it up
here
for Joe.
He's at the back
oh, my
in the
God.
Corner.
Joe, you're a king. So this was a night shoot, which we talked yes. a little bit about.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell everyone like what a night? I mean, I think a lot of industries here for sure. Hollywood's in the room.
Well, do you guys know what a night shoot is? Because I certainly fucking didn't.
Yeah.
So, well, it was in the Paramount parking lot. So where we created that scene when we filled it with water was actually where in the daytime people park their cars, right? When they're going to work and stuff like that. So obviously we had to do it at night when they weren't there. It is Ophelia at the end. Yeah, no, look at you. Yeah.
We'll get to you.
So we had to do it at nighttime. So they were like, you're good to do a night shoot. I was like, yeah. I thought a night shoot would be like 2 p.m. till 10 p.m. or something like that. But actually it was 10 p.m. till 6 a.m., which I need my sleep. Like, I'm a real homebody. And it was also freezing. We shot it, like, you know, in like around this time last year, really, wasn't it? It was like fall. It was freezing. And I wasn't going to get wet, but fucking hell, I did get wet. So I was freezing cold. I had a wet arse and wearing like a 10,000 pound dress. Yeah. Like, you know, so it was a night shoot. It was two nights in a row. So I'd get home. Yeah, I'd get home at like 5 or 6. Yeah, as everyone else was getting up to go home.
Were you ever just like in there? Because they're all around, so they can like be on land, but you're in the water. So were you just ever like left out there? And you're just kind of like, hey, like,
yeah,
can I get a glam touch up?
Because for me to get out of it, get in and out of it was quite a lot.
Okay.
But you know, I definitely had a few tantrums. I was like, I'm fucking done. And I went home and then like, my stylist would have to blow dry me because I'd be so wet. They put me in a scuba diving outfit underneath. It was so unflattering.
Yeah.
And there was only one of them set to blow dry every time there was a break in the shoot and stuff like that. But I mean, it was worth it.
It really was worth it. Yeah.
It was worth
can we talk
it,
about
yeah.
the dress? Everyone's here. We're like, The dress
was beautiful. Dress. Yeah, that was Valentino. They made it. Oh, wow. Jamie, what they made it? They made it with like a week's notice, I think. And
love you, Jamie.
And they only made one. And Jamie was going to check if you know, did she get wet? Because if so, we can make a few. Yeah, she's not going to get wet. So we just had the one, but it didn't get ruined. I got to wear it.
Just like a soggy gold sequin dress.
Yeah,
in
that.
Water.
Cool. Yeah, that dress has been through it, boy. Yeah.
Yeah. I love that.
Yeah. She was actually here earlier, the dress, but the mannequin looked like a weirdo. So I was like. I was like, no, so I took the dress back home.
Okay, perfect. I'll try it on later.
Yeah, you should
I'm really
see
excited.
You, yeah.
Okay, we do have questions from the audience.
Amazing.
So I want to ask Lorena if she wants to ask her question. I have it here.
Where are you, Lorena?
Lorena.
Oh, you're right there. Sorry,
oh, my God,
darling.
Hi. Okay, I think they're going to give you a mic. Here they come.
Oh, she comes.
Hollywood. Here we go. Hey, Adele. That's Adele. Everyone go crazy. Wait, I'm like, that's Adele. It's crazy. Okay.
Okay.
Lorena, take it away.
So I'm trying to remember what I asked, but I remember it was, what is your favorite phrase in the whole song?
Of I Drink Wine?
Yes, if I Drink Wine.
Definitely sometimes the road best traveled is a road best left behind. I blew my own socks off with that one.
Ooh, that's
when
what
I wrote
right,
it, I was
down.
Like, oh, I was like, oh, oh, oh. Yeah, I think that one. And I just, you know, I also... Sometimes, you know, when you haven't experienced everything from a situation that you want to, you feel like you don't ever have any closure, but sometimes actually you don't need it, you know, and sometimes it coming to an end is the closure that you need, and sometimes you cling on a bit too long, which is definitely the story of my life. But I try and really, like, listen to myself with that lyric, but yeah. Quick question, how'd you get that coat, babes?
So I actually went to Vegas.
Okay.
Girl strip.
Okay.
So we went to the store. I don't remember being in the store. It was so amazing. It was like a whole experience. And we were so, I was so excited to be able to get it. So I was like, okay, I'm going to wear it here. I can wear it in Vegas. So I love it. It's amazing. So yeah, we went out to Vegas and went to your store, which is
did your tickets
beautiful.
Get reallocated? Are you still
yes,
going to be coming?
Yes, yes,
oh, okay.
Yes,
what show are you,
you
coming to?
We're going on the 25th.
Perfect.
Yes. Well, second weekend.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm like, perfect. I'm opening. You're going to love it. The show is
my boyfriend Rich is always saying that he's opening as well.
Just
that'd be hilarious.
Nice little 10-minute set. Okay, we have another one. Kate Austin, this is the best. This is my favorite because I think you screwed up at the beginning and then it just says...
She's here at the front.
Zoom in.
She's here at the front.
Yeah, it just says, fuck. Sorry, ignore. So I'll just give this to you and you can ask in case you forgot. There you go. Hello, rock. Gorgeous ring. Let's go. Give that to Adele. Seriously, bring your gifts.
What's the most important thing you ever learned at the lowest you've ever been?
Being patient. I remember when I, the day after we announced our divorce, which sounds really shit, but we thought that we had to announce it in case, because people started noticing that we weren't together, and I didn't want it to look dodgy, because it wasn't. And then we thought that by sort of announcing it on Good Friday that it would get buried in the Easter news, but obviously it blew up. And I remember the day after, one of my really good friends from London had flown home with me, because I'd been in London just before, just to, you know, make sure I wasn't on my own. And I just remember looking at him and being like, how long am I going to feel like this? And he was like, I don't know, you're going to have to like ride the wave and be patient. And once I actually started doing that, I started making progress. But I'm a control freak, I'm a Taurus, like, you know. And yeah, I was really put in my place. I was really put in my place, and I spent a lot of time on my own, and it was really, really hard. I remember my therapist, he said to me, you've got to go sit with your five-year-old self, she's on her own. I was like, oh, FD.
Like, Adele, it's a fun night. Like.
Yeah. So, yeah, being patient, I think. Also, I've got a question for you. How'd you get that ponytail like that? It looks amazing. Oh, is it? Oh, it's very good. Absolutely. It's very perfect.
It's done.
Yeah.
Oh, she just whipped it. That was cute. I love that. Okay, that was a beautiful question. Okay, we have Sarah. Benjamin? Sarah Benjamin? There she is. Here we go. Do you want it? You asked two.
Okay, I asked two.
Do you remember it?
Yes.
Okay, great.
The first one's long shot. But, like, can we gamble in Vegas together? Or, like, what's the vibe?
Sure. You know, I've never gambled because I think I'd get addicted to it. But, yeah, sure. Not when he comes to Vegas.
February 25th.
Oh, that's better. Yeah, I'll be in my rhythm then. Yeah, I'll be in my rhythm. I actually go on 12 hours voice rest right after a show, which is hell for me. But by February, I'll be more in my rhythm, so that'll be fine. Yes,
okay,
for sure.
I'll follow up with you then.
Okay.
I love you so much. Oh, what part of the like Vegas residency are you most excited about?
The whole reason I wanted to perform in that room was because of how small it is. You know, it's like 4,000 capacity room is small, like, you know, especially compared to my last tour. And as much as I love my last tour, I couldn't see most of them. They could have been photoshopped in for all I knew, you know. I couldn't see their faces and stuff like that. No, but it's like 100,000 people. It's a lot of fucking people, like, you know. And you can't see them. And, the people at the front, I can see how much they're enjoying it, and also trying to imagine what it is that they're revisiting, because they get very into it, like, you know, and sometimes it's like they don't even know I'm there. They're just sort of like getting lost in it, and I can experience that in there. So I think the intimacy of it, and obviously fucking opening night at last, Jesus. So yeah, those two things.
Thank you.
I'll see you there. Start saving for that
row
building.
F.
Row F. Where? Row up.
Like right
up top?
In the middle, like 104.
All right, I'll see you then. F104, right there.
Okay. Also, Adele, remember seriously. Yeah. Wait, I love, because you said love you so much. I was like, oh, she added that. No, you wrote that.
Oh,
wrote
that. I love that.
That's very sweet.
I'm going to keep all of these.
Yeah. Okay, good. I'm going to keep some too. Yeah. Okay. I'm like, it's a big night for me, Adele. Okay, wait, I have one question. Did you drink real wine on the shoot?
Oh, no.
At least a little bit?
No.
At the end?
No, it wasn't, was it? No, it was like 4 a.m.
You were pissed.
I can't get pissed. I was like, hypothermia.
Yeah, okay, you're working. You're a professional.
And also, I remember I had to sing along. Like, you know, I always forget my lyrics when I'm drunk. No, yeah. Wasn't it like juice? Yeah, it was like apple juice tinted with something, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I drink white wine, but you couldn't really see the white wine in the cups. So we had to make it a little bit rosé. And I do like red wine, but I get some sloshed.
Okay.
Like one glass, I'm on the floor, I can drink white wine all night. And I mix it with
fizzy. Tonight's the night, Adele.
I mix it with fizzy drink. I've got a show in a few weeks, but God, fuck it, I'll have a cup.
That's my girl.
It's half and half. It's Perrier and white wine.
Oh, perfect.
Spritzer.
Do you like hard alcohol too, or is this strictly wine?
Well, you know, it's fun.
Let's talk about it. We're here to talk about it.
Well, first of all, I don't want to turn into Tom Waits, as much as I love Tom Waits. You know, Tom Waits has the deepest, graveliest voice you've ever heard in your life, which is like amazing, but I don't think my fans would enjoy it from me. But my boyfriend has a tequila company, so but tequila Hello. Makes me a bit violent, you know.
Oh really?
It's like not physically violent,
yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah.
I'll pick a fight. I'll start a fight.
Oh god.
For no reason.
Like
yeah. Does anyone else have that with certain drinks?
drinks. Yeah.
Isn't it weird?
Yeah.
Is anyone else having it with tequila?
Yes, yes.
Okay, but then I try and drink it because they say it's low in calories and all of that. But
a violent crowd, yeah. I love that.
And I also can't drink it neat. I need ginger ale, and then it gives me acid reflux. It's a bit of a... disaster.
We'll stick to wine. Yeah, no, wine I think is perfect. Okay, we have video questions. Ooh. Tech, I love it.
Will they be on there?
Okay, Annie from London. Here we go. Hell yeah, girl.
Hi Adele, I'm Annie and I'm from London. And my question is, on your journey to self-love while writing 30, did your perspective on how you saw yourself when you wrote 25 change at all and how? Cheers, babes, love ya.
Where's she from? Enfield or something? Love that. She said my name perfectly. Yeah. He came and asked me how I say Adele. My name and I was like, Adele.
How was
she
mine?
Was like, hi, Adele.
Did you? Adele?
Adele.
Adele.
Okay. Great. All right, from London. On 25, I was very in control of my life. I just had my son. And, you know, it was very much 9 to 5 that I'd go to the studio and stuff like that. And I was also coming off the back of an album that grew its own pair of legs and ran around the world a few times. But I felt very, very safe and in safe hands, like within my private life. On 30, I just had to just accept that I had no idea what I was doing. I had no control over my life, and I had to like ride the wave. Like that's all what I was saying to you. So I didn't really rate myself as a human being very much when I was writing 30. I felt like a bad person. I felt like a weak person. But I knew I had to, the only thing that I wanted to do, the only thing that got me out of bed really, was knowing I would be going to the studio, because I love singing and stuff like that. So yeah, I guess I fell really far down in my estimations of myself when I was writing it. But then by the end, through all the hard work and patience, I restored my faith in myself, I think. So yeah.
Does watching the videos and stuff bring you back to those emotions, or do you feel like there's some distance?
The music video, like itself,
yeah,
I was fine then. I mean, I'm still am in a great place. I was like new and fresh in a relationship. I was ready to rumble. But it'd be interesting to see that when we get to Vegas. I've been in rehearsals for a couple of weeks, and obviously I did the London shows, and I was also really rehearsed for Vegas that didn't happen. But it'll be interesting singing some of the new songs a lot.
Yeah,
you know, like over a period of time with the audience, because I feel like it will really bring it alive for me, and I haven't exhausted those songs yet, like, yeah. So I will have to relive it a little bit, I think, but...
Are there some that you're just like, I can't believe I have to sing this still?
No, I mean, do you know what? Yeah, like one time, I went to a Radiohead show once, right? And they didn't fucking sing Creep. I was so annoyed.
That's not right.
I was so annoyed, and I get it, but, like, I would never do that, just because of how pissed off I was.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't ever want anyone to be like... And also, I'm just like, let me ask me again when I'm, like, 60.
We'll be here.
If someone like
we'll
you in the set, room. I'll be like, hell, no, it's not. But, no, there's none that I feel... There's an interstitial in the show.
Okay, there we go.
And it uses a voice note, and I can't, in rehearsal, I leave the room, so I don't know what's going to happen when I'm stuck with the fucking in-ears in for it. But, yeah, that I can't revisit. But, yeah, we'll see.
Okay.
But, yeah, thanks for your question.
Yeah, I love
you,
girl.
She's probably fast asleep if she's in London.
No, she's up. Love you, girl. okay, we have another one from Adnan.
She's up?
She's up.
Oh, amazing.
She's up. Do you know her? Wait, okay, amazing. I love that. There's connections here.
Hello, Adele. I'm Adnan from Pakistan, and I'm such a big fan of yours. And my question for you is, whose music helped you in your tough time and gave you hope like you have given to millions of people around the world? And when are you going to do world tour? We are waiting eagerly for that. And best of luck to you from Pakistan. Thank you.
That was two questions, babe.
Seriously. Adnan, absolutely not. Answer one.
Oh, I suddenly started sweating, boy. My top lip. I think Donny Hathaway, especially the last sort of like 4 or 5 years. I've always loved him, but there's just something in his voice that just makes me feel okay about falling apart. And his lyrics are stunning, and his like chord progressions, and then like you always think you can sing along, but he's always just behind the beat, so you fail miserably. His music just moves me and really cuddled me during all of that, really. Bon Iver, I used to listen to a lot as well when I was writing 25 and a lot of 21.
My favourite Gabrielle, like, reminds me of, like, when I was little and stuff like that, and there's always, like, a nice autumnal evening for me. And I have no plans right now to do a world tour, just because I know it was years ago, but I am still recovering from doing the last one, because I did it with a three-year-old. He came everywhere with me. But where I'm at in my personal life, like, we're very steady, and my child is very grounded and centred in his new scenario, and I can't pull him out of that, and I can't not see him. So right now I'm not. But, you know, it ain't that long until it's 21 years of 21, you know.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You know, and there'll be no COVID at all then, you know. Damn. So, and I can start planning it now.
I have my set planned. I'm ready.
Yeah. I mean, what is it, like 8 years? That's going to fly by, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
These lot are like, see you then, babe. Wah, yeah. Wah. You're the best. We'll see you then. Okay. Let's see what I got in here. Oh, okay. Amy Giron. She's like, oh,
hi.
Fuck. Okay.
Do you remember your question?
It's long.
I do. No, well, the top part is fine.
Okay.
Yeah. First, I want to say I love you.
Thank you. I was in Vegas opening night.
Oh, you were?
But it's okay. FaceTime. So, okay. Honestly, okay. I've been fine up until now. So, don't worry. But I just want to know what your fans and your daydreamers mean to you.
Well, I have a lot. I mean, I have recently deleted, well, not that recently, a little while ago, deleted all of my social media fake ones.
Yeah.
But I get pure shits and giggles out of reading your tweets and stuff like that. But to have a group of people that, like, you know, I remember the first time I really became aware of it was when I cancelled the last two shows at Wembley. And, like, you lot all turned up, and, you know, and sang the songs and stuff like that. It made the news in London, you know. It was on the air. It was on, like, the 6 o'clock news. And that was the first time I realised that even, like, because of me, outside of me, you created this lovely group. And it was really beautiful. And then I saw a lot of it when I was in London for a few days for Hyde Park. And it's just, like, there's so many, you know, like, for real, Beyonce, that's how I'm friends with a lot of my best friends, was through our mutual love of Beyonce, and they're people that I can't remember and can't imagine my life without. So, like, and that being our core truth, is that, like, us being a fan of someone is really wholesome, and I love it, and it's just a joy. It's a joy to watch, and having, like, stans is quite, like... Oh. Is it quite a vibe?
Daydreamers? Is that what they're called? Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Well, they call themselves daydreamers. Okay. And then in Hyde Park, I, like I said, bye, daydreamers. They lost their fucking shit.
Oh, I love that. Yeah. Wait, say it in the cam.
Where's the... What
this one?
Daydreamers.
Done. Hey, daydreamers. Wait, that's so fun.
Well, they're the ones watching it, aren't they? Because of... The people that were invited online, because, I mean, some people were invited with, like, 3 days' notice. They live in fucking London. They can't fucking get in.
No, they're watching.
I know. That's what I mean. So we put it online as well. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So this is only daydreamers.
But the only people
realm.
That are watching it, I imagine, would be daydreamers. Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah.
I didn't know there was a title. I feel really good.
How the hell did you get this job?
I'm a freaking daydreamer. Literally. Literally.
Is it cute as well?
It's really cute. I thought maybe I was going to ask that and you'd be like, I don't, you know, I can't name my fan base. But they name themselves.
They name themselves.
Okay.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here we go. Oh, someone. Penmanship. Let's go. Taylor Kirby. Where the hell are you?
Oh. Can I get another off and off?
Hi, Adele.
Hi, darling.
I'm not going to stand up. My 9-year-old self is crying right now. Oh my gosh.
Way to make me feel old.
Well, okay, to be fair, I'm 21, so I'm.
Are you? I can't get out to see. Sorry, the lights are so bright.
No, we're totally good. My question is, what are some things you've been doing lately that have been making you happy?
Oh, yeah, I like that question. Been buying a lot of clothes.
Good girl.
Online shopping, girl. Yeah. But you know what I did do, though, because I'm actually a bit of... I'm not a hoarder. I just like to buy a lot of things because I don't really do very much. And not in like a Michael Jackson way of like, I'll have that one and I'll have this one. Not like that. But just like, I'm always like, what if I need an outfit for this? I don't go anywhere, right? So I had this spare bedroom in my house, and it was just filled with rails of stuff, and I gave it all away, and I have this new clear bedroom, which is amazing. But I do love to buy things, like sneakers and just sweats. I have so many sweats and stuff like that. I actually got into, and it's the only app I've ever spent money on, and I'm really annoyed at myself. I've become obsessed with this word game. I actually don't know what it's called, and my phone's on charge in the car. but it's where you get given six letters and you have to. Do you know what one I mean?
Oh, Wordle.
Wordle.
Yeah.
No, it's not the one that they used to post on the New York Times. No, but it's like that. And I'm on like level 900. I'd say that. And my dogs. Really hanging out with my dogs and then making special time for Rich and stuff like that. And I mean, the season just started, and believe me, I'm actually a really big basketball fan. Thank God. So I've also been doing that. I'd like to start learning how to sketch a bit better at some point. But you know, it's funny because I always say to my friends, I'm like, I need a hobby because my hobby is singing, but it's also my job now. So it kind of takes that thing I do for myself away from it. So it's a very good question, but yeah, online shopping and this Wordle game is not very glamorous. It's not very glamorous. What album came out when you were 9?
21.
Whoa.
Yeah.
So with that.
Do you know, I've had so many, and I'm so moved by that. Thank you. The other day, my guitarist had to correct me because I was talking about Hometown Glory with my backup singers. And I was like, I wrote it as a protest song. I was like, you know, it's been a long time since Tony Blair was prime minister. You know, it's been like 10 years. And Ben was like, it was 20 years ago. And also now, like, all the new girls, like, in the industry and stuff like that, when I meet them, I was at Beyonce's birthday party a few weeks ago, and I met a few of them. And they were like, when I was 7, and I'm like, oh.
When I was 2, Chasing Pavements changed my life.
I'm like, oh, I'm one of them now. I'm like older, like, you know, but it's beautiful. Thank you. It's so, so lovely to hear that.
Okay, we're ripping through them. How you doing?
I'm good. Oh, here it comes.
Oh, hell yeah.
Thank you. Oh, you look beautiful.
Chug it, sweetie.
Oh, thank you so much.
Love you. Okay, Kim. Where are you, sweetie? This is a long question. Do you need it?
Do you remember it or do you want it?
Okay. Hey, we're just here for you, okay? Don't yell at me and Adele.
Well, hi.
Hi.
So my question for you is there a topic or a field of study that you wish you'd be more knowledgeable about or you're interested in learning?
Well, after Vegas, I really want to get a degree in English literature. It's something that if I hadn't made it in my singing, I think I would definitely be a teacher. I think I'd be an English lit teacher. And even though I probably would never use it, although, you know, I do, obviously I don't have a degree, but I do feel, remember my teacher that was on my show that I met, like how much she made me fall in love with books and making sure that my writing was eligible so that my stories could be told. Like, I definitely think I use my passion of English lit in what I do. But even though it's not like I'd go on to get a job from my degree, which also I feel like some of my friends are at college and I'm like, what do you want to do? And it has nothing to do with their chosen subject. It's so bizarre. But I wish I'd gone to university. I wish I'd had that experience. I won't go to university. I'll do it online and with a tutor. But that's my plan. That's my plan for like 2025. Just to get the qualifications that I would need to do it. So that's exactly
Thank
what
you,
I
Adele.
Guess. Where are you from?
I'm from Montreal.
Oh, lovely.
Hello.
Yeah.
You play it?
Lovely.
Yeah, we flew in.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, Jonathan, yeah. Right next to you. That's the infamous Jonathan.
That's daydreamer number one.
Well,
Let's
yes.
Go.
Well, I was stalking him, and then I saw him in front row in London. Yeah.
Got it.
In my pocket.
Do you want to ask a question?
Yeah.
Go.
Sure.
Take the mic.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. So my question is, we heard your Desert Island disc interview where you said, you know, 5 songs you would bring on a desert island. What 5 movies would you bring in, and is it Spice World included?
Ooh, is Spice World included? Well, Titanic is my number one.
Ooh.
Or it is. I had a Titanic-themed 30th birthday. It was a bit controversial, but it was a laugh.
Absolutely.
I'm going to say Goodfellas. I do love a gangster movie. I would say Godfather 1 and 2, but that's taking up a lot of my list.
A lot of
I'm going to say I take a Sister Act 1. I take Sister Act 1 with me. And I'm actually not saying this because I'm here. I would take The Last Black Man in San Francisco. That movie really resonated with my soul. It really, really, really did. So was that 4 or 5? That was 4. And then Spice World.
Good choice. Good choice.
Yeah, for sure.
Some of those are music movies. Would you ever act?
I'd love to act, yeah.
Hey,
I know what movie I want to do. It's
I'm like, okay, yeah, let's go.
No, it's I don't want to do. I often get things. I often get asked to do things that are music related, which I think is too obvious. for me to do. And but years ago, I went to a dinner party with some friends of mine, and the husband was like, "Oh, she'd be perfect for this." And I was like, "What is it?" And they would tell it. He was telling me the whole story of it, and I was like, "Okay, great. So who would I be?" And he's like, "You be her." And it's kind of, I think I would nail it. Not that I've ever acted, so I have no fucking idea.
That's all it takes, Adele.
No idea, but I love them, and I feel like I could, because I love them, I think I could actually do it justice. But he's not writing the script right now, so I've just got to wait. But that's fine, you know, I've got Vegas and family stuff.
You're a little busy,
but at some point I'd love to, but probably not music.
Okay.
Probably not.
Yeah. Maybe like one song on the soundtrack.
Mate, although, do you know what? Yeah, I remember when I saw Elvis, did anyone see Elvis? Did you like it? Oh, interesting. I fucking loved it.
Yeah.
How he managed to humanize Elvis, like, woof. And I sent him a text like, being like, "I wish I was in this movie. Please don't retire. Let me do something." So maybe that kind of music thing, but I wouldn't sing in it.
Okay.
You know, I'd just be like, I don't know. I probably would just be singing in it, really.
Yeah, yeah. So I'd be like, yeah. I can't wait for a director to be like, "Yeah, we need someone to sing in this scene." Yeah. Like, do we have anyone?
No, I would act. Yeah, but only one movie. I'll do one movie.
And then you're
fuck
done.
Fuck off, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, yeah.
When a golden globe, you're
story
out.
Story of my life.
Okay, great. Done. Okay, we have another video. From Lazola from South Africa. Yeah.
Hi, Adele. This is Lazola from South Africa. Once again, thank you for this opportunity. So my question is, since you all know your albums are personal to you, so when your albums are finished, who is that one person you first play your new songs to and why? Thank you.
Great question. It's my best friend, Laura. Back home in London. Yeah, Laura Dockrell. We've been best friends since I was about 13 or 14. And she just knows me better than anyone else in the world. So she'll be like, "This is shit." Or like, "I don't believe you. I don't believe your lyrics," or like, "Whatever. I think you could do better." Like, you know, or she'll be like, try and like, be like, "Why don't you go listen to some like Incubus and get some like chord ideas?" She loves Incubus. And we used to go to so many shows together when I was a teenager. So she's like, and she comes to all of my shows as well. So it's like, she's like, "Could you do this song live?" You know, if it's a bit too like, you know, like, oh my God, she loved. And she was like, "Whoa, what a bop." But she was like, "How are you going to do that live?" And I'm like, "I don't know." Because I only have, you know, everything is played at my shows. So we had to sort of do a live version of it in London rather than like all the fancy computer sounds and all that. But she just honest, really. And obviously, because I talk to her every day about things I'm going through, she is a very good sort of scale of if I'm being truthful or not to myself, not just to other people. So, yeah, my best friend, Laura.
What does she do when she loves the song? Is she like, "This is a
bop"? She loves it, and she'll just start trying to sing it. And she's like, "Ooh," like, yeah, she really goes.
Does she have a favorite?
She gets,
what's her favorite?
What's her favorite? She very publicly wrote about it. She had a bit of a life crisis, a couple of years before the album came out. So she definitely does love this album. I think she likes My Little Love, I think, the most off of that one. Yeah.
That's a good choice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. We've got, oh my God. Okay. Liliana from Mexico. We're all over the world. Daydreamers. It's a video.
Oh, a video.
It's a video.
Oh, big fan.
Okay. I think she knows your work.
Is what are your top 3 moments to drink wine?
Thank you
so much. Cheers.
Oh, Sundays. I like to day drink on a Sunday. Okay.
Absolutely.
Won't be doing that once the show starts. Sundays, vacation, like going on holiday and stuff like that. Drink all day, like pina coladas are my daytime drink.
Okay.
And then I'll move on to red wine. It depends where I am, you know. I had a lot of red wine in Italy when I was there in the summer. I had no hangovers. They must make it pure, you know.
Ooh,
I don't know what
do.
They're putting in it out here.
Yeah, they do.
And what's the third time? I like drinking on my own. Is that a bit worrying?
No, not at all.
Okay, yeah.
Making a drink by yourself is there's something special.
And then
I
put my headphones in and like think that Beyonce's invited me on stage. Yeah. I get really into it. I don't drink when I'm doing my shows, so... none of my friends probably want to hang out with me. Probably boring.
It's okay.
I don't
I'll be there. Just text me, okay?
Okay, great. You'll probably be there drunk.
No,
and then I'll be sober.
No. I'm a professional. Okay, Gabby, this is your moment. Where the hell are you?
She's over here.
There she is.
Hi. Hi. I'm so nervous. Oh, my gosh. I love you. And we want to know when you're going to go to Brazil. We are Brazilians here.
Come to Brazil.
Come to Brazil.
I really did have every intention of taking the 25 tour there. There were just things outside of my control that stopped it. And I know I said it so many times on stage, and then I think I saw it on the front page of a newspaper there that I wasn't coming, and I was like, oh, my God, they're never going to want me back. Yeah. We are actually, and I don't know, again, I'm going to put the disclaimer straight away. I don't know if it's going to be possible.
Just so you know, it was not a serious newspaper.
It wasn't, yeah. Okay, it was like a tabloid, like The Sun, fuck them. Okay. Yeah. Okay. disclaimer, I don't know what I want to do. I don't know if it is possible, like legally. I don't know if it's possible. But I would definitely, in my dream world, I would end this whole campaign in Brazil, because I've never been. And you lot have been consistent as anything, my God. And I probably wouldn't even be able to sing at my own show there. I probably wouldn't be able to hear myself. But I have every intention, and I always have had every intention since I started. I promise you, I wasn't just lying. Because also, you lot come from all around the world. You come see me, and it's just... And Raven, like my photographer, everyone comments. Her boyfriend's Portuguese, so now he gets to, like, translate all the messages. They write her! And like my best is come to Brazil all the time, and they're like, I'm not Adele, why would I come to Brazil? But no, I have every intention of absolutely doing it. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Okay. Before we do have the last question.
Have you come from Brazil? Yes. Fuck off.
Oh my God.
Have you really?
Daydreamers travel. Oh, I love God. That.
You are? Oh my gosh. So I've got to fucking go.
I came from Silver Lake, so that's something to think about. Kind of crazy.
I literally live two roads away.
That's my girl! Okay, so before we ask this last question, which has nothing to do with the video, I thought we would bring it back to I Drink Wine. Do you have a favorite moment in the video?
I like it when someone starts filling up my glass.
That's my favorite.
You know, yeah. And I'm like, oh, that's weird, but not really. And then I carry on drinking.
Let's go.
The video, there's parts of it, it's also a bit about sisterhood, I think, with what Joe did in the video, of just like the guy, it weren't working with the guy, and my friends were like, this doesn't seem like a great idea. You're trying to, like, and then they physically removed me from it and stuff like that, but they'd come and drink my sorrows away with me.
Yeah.
And it got to the point where I was like, I can't drink anymore, I'm not making any fucking progress, and just drunk all the fucking time. So it's just, I don't know, it's probably, but yeah, I'd say probably when someone's filling up my glass, because it really was, it wasn't, you know, it was my medication when I was feeling like that, sadly.
Yeah. And like when all the girls come up and like take him away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly, yeah. They were like, they'd make up blatant lies that I would fall for just to make me be like, it's over, go away.
This is it.
Yeah.
Okay, Sebastian, this is my favorite question. You have to ask it. Oh, he's giggling. He knows.
Oh, no, what is it?
First, hi.
Hi.
We know the sad Adele, but I just wanted to know what your stripper name was.
Well, sometimes they say, isn't it your pet and your road, the street name? So that would be.
Don't say your street name.
No, isn't it the street you grew up on or something?
Oh, the street. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, so it was Diamond Shelbourne would be mine. Diamond Shelbourne.
Hello.
But also Shanisa Stop is like my Zoom name and stuff like that, which is she needs to stop.
Yeah.
Like, but you say it fast and it sounds like Shanisa Stop. Yeah. Probably Diamond Shelbourne. It's actually quite a good stripper name, isn't it?
That's hot.
Well, you know, if it all falls apart in Vegas, come catch me down the road.
You'll be at the gambling table and on the tables. Let's go. Sebastian, what's yours?
Yeah, good question.
I honestly have no idea.
Okay.
What's your first pet?
I kind of freaked out.
What's your first pet?
My first what?
Pet.
Pearly.
Pearly. And then what's the name of the street you grew up on?
38.
Pearly 38. Oh, oi.
Mine's Susie Tonkin, so I don't know if that's really...
Sound like a teacher.
Yeah, I don't know about that. Yeah, no, like she can get a little teacher. Fucking nasty. Oh, I swore. Sorry. Wait, you can swear with Adele. Fuck.
Yeah,
okay,
fuck,
cool.
Fuck.
Oh, thank God. Okay, before we leave, is there anything you want to say,
No,
Adele?
But I want some more questions.
Yeah, should we do more? Yeah. We can do more, right? Who cares?
But don't be rude or reaching, okay?
Yes. With the questions. Don't you dare. Okay, right here. Can we give him a mic? Here, yes. Hey, love you.
Hi, Adele.
Love you. Hi.
Hey. I just want to say thank you. We just got married this weekend, so we're not going on a honeymoon. This is basically our honeymoon seeing you.
Oh, I love that.
So we're big Broadway fans. We know you have your ego. Almost. Your Tony, do you have any plans on going on Broadway? Acting, not singing.
Oh, is that possible?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that. I can't lie, guys. I'm not a massive Broadway fan. Okay, I know, I know. I'm talking about musicals though, because I've been to see a couple of plays, but I don't think I've seen enough. I've seen a lot of. He is like, who are you? He's like, hey.
He's like, we can go.
Yeah, let's go. Fuck it. But there was one I saw, and I can't remember the name of it. It's a really famous one, so this is really embarrassing. It's one about the pushy mother who has the daughter that's going to be a star.
Gypsy.
I saw that. It was like,
I'm like, easy.
It's like a really game show. I saw that. In London, and I did love the role of the mum in it. Like, you know, when she does her song where she's just like, I wanted to do all of this, and she's like jealous of her own daughter, and she's really caught up about it at one point. Otherwise, she's just a bitch in it, which I think I could nail. I don't think I've seen enough as a grown up to know if I would want to do it. I was wondering, do I just move the show from Vegas to Broadway and win a Tony? No.
Yeah, that counts.
I actually prefer the sound of an ego than an ego.
Oh, yeah. It's quite Ego's fun. Cute. That's cute.
Ego's fun. Yeah. But yeah, you know, I never say never. You know, like if I move to New York, you know, I'll get bored. I'll be on that stage in a hot second.
Yeah.
You know, for sure. What's your favorite Broadway shows?
Oh, I'm basic. I like Wicked.
Hello, Dolly.
Ooh. Okay. Do you know, I never saw. Have you seen the new one?
I saw. Bernadette and Bette Midler in it.
You
recently.
See the Bette Midler one.
I saw both of them.
I didn't get to go and see it. What about the my fucking knowledge is fucking shit. The massive one that Lea Michele's in.
Funny girl.
Have you seen the new one of that?
I'm going to New York next week, so yes, I'll go.
You are a big fan. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. We're still a daydreamer first.
Okay. Always daydreamers.
Okay. Do you know the other thing as well is that I actually know Bette Midler, which is a big flex, right? Because she's one of my idols. And she's like... She's like, you would never be able to keep up with the schedule on Broadway. Because like, I'm so lazy. I'm so notoriously. Oh, come on.
I don't think
See
you are.
See how no one said no in the crowd?
Yeah, the whole crowd silent.
I would Your not be able to do matinees and all of that. Yeah. I don't have the stamina for that. Like, you know.
It's just a show every now and then you pop in.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
That's enough for Broadway.
But if I ever do, I'll invite you for the opening night.
Okay. Wonderful. Thank you.
Okay. Who else? Adele picks.
No, you pick.
Don't you dare.
You pick.
Okay, yeah, well, what if they ask something crazy? Then it's all...
Then I'll be like, no.
Me. Yeah, oh, that's good. No! Wait,
no!
Can we do that together? One, two, three.
No!
Okay, that'll be what we'll do. Yes, right here.
I am a new mom.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. And so I was wondering if there was anything that you experienced with your son in the first, you know, few years of his life that you feel was really poignant and how strong your relationship with him is now.
Ooh.
Okay.
Good question. Crikey. Well, we were together nonstop. I'm gonna have like nannies when I next have a baby, because I can't. No, honestly, I was like a shell of a human being when I had Angelo. I couldn't emotionally and physically. I couldn't keep up with how much. I don't like. It's incredible that most women do it sometimes without a partner as well. Like, it blew my mind. But I think it's probably the first time he like fell over and hurt himself, and he needed me and he wanted me. Like, you know, and there was. Like, Simon was in the room, I think my mum was in the room, like, my auntie was in the room, and he needed me, and it was the first time in my life that I ever felt needed, and it was very profound. But I've definitely had more. It only gets better when you're a new mum, and it everything happens very slowly. He was 10 last week, you know. It was like the slowest time of my life, but I turn around and he's like literally got a diamond earring, a gold chain, and a fucking phone. Like, you know, it's like, I've got to make an appointment to fucking hang out with my kid. But it only gets better. And when they become human and have empathy for you, like last summer, we moved into this new place in London, and I was really overwhelmed by it all. And I, like, nothing was working and things like that. And he just gave me a cuddle and he's like, I'm sorry you're having a bad day. And that human connection as he's getting older is like profound. But it was the first time he needed me. I was like, oh, my role is important here, like, you know. And it was, are you having a great time being a new mum?
Yeah, she's becoming a little person.
Yeah, how old is she now?
She'll be 9 months in a couple of days.
Right, yeah, amazing. What's been your moment? Have you had that moment yet?
She's home most often with my wife, so okay. She's the one who gets wanted a okay. lot. So honestly, it's kind of the opposite for me. It's okay. just like I want to be wanted.
Yeah.
And it's hard because I'm working all the time and AJ's home with her. So
right.
I'm hopeful for that day. I'm excited to experience
it. It flips as well. I've got a boy, but he wanted me nonstop for 6 years, and then now he just wants his dad. Like, you know, and he has equal time with both of us, but their relationship, it took on a different meaning as he got older. So I'm sure that will come
yeah.
for sure.
Yeah.
It'll be the cool one that, you know, that doesn't like, you got to do this, you got to do that. Cause that's definitely me. I'm like, get upstairs and go do this. For sure. You know, his dad's like fun and stuff like that. But congratulations.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
I think in an interview you said that like you took your son to a Taylor Swift concert and he's like, she's amazing.
Yeah.
Now that he's grown, is he like, you're Adele?
We did have that moment this summer. That was such an incredible moment when it was to the Reputation. His buzz in music for himself, like, you know, him being interested in it for sure was Taylor. And then now he's like very like emo-y and like very into Billie Eilish and stuff like that. And we went to that show together and that was also phenomenal. And then 2 days later, he came to my shows in London. And I swear to God, it feels like he now respects me.
No, I mean, as he should.
Like, because I think sometimes when I'm like, I'm on the phone, like, I'm on a work call, get out of the room, stop making that noise, or I've got to go to a meeting. He's like, what the hell do you do? Like, he's like, how are you on the phone all the time? And where? What do you mean you're going? You just all you do is get your makeup done and like, say you're going out for dinner. So I don't want to be like, I've got to go out for a meeting. I'm like, I'm going out for dinner, so it makes sense to him. And then now if I'm on the phone and I'm like, 1 minute, he's like,
work on the album. Yeah.
And he was I think it was you could kind of say, I mean, a lot of my friends and stuff were with him watching the show in London, but I think seeing Billie Eilish and then him seeing people coming to my show, like how he went to hers, was probably quite overwhelming for him. But it's a real vibe. Like, he's coming to opening night in Vegas. He's like, I need to have a plan. I get to miss school on Friday so I can come with you. Like,
hell yeah. And he's like your tour manager.
Yeah, but he, Taylor was his first musical love. Yeah. Yeah.
So sweet.
Yeah, he really
Do you think he like ever went to sleepovers and a mom was singing and he's like,
he doesn't have sleepovers. Voice they come sucks. To our house.
Oh, work. Okay, good.
Whose voice sucks? My voice?
No. If he went to like another person's house and a mom and was like singing like and he was like, huh.
Oh, he doesn't rate me as a singer. Like, fuck that. One time I was singing Happier Than Ever and he was like, it just sounds better when Billy does it. I was like, oh, I know. And Angelo's nanny, she was like, hoo-hoo. She was like, ah. And I was like, fair play. But we sing it every morning, Happier Than Ever. We sing every morning on the way to school, full voice, swearing, everything. Yeah, and I like,
let's go.
I bring my left leg up and I start kicking it. We love it. Yeah, we absolutely love it.
We'll do that at the end.
He's also into, he like plays me people's songs now. And he's like, what do you think of this? Ukulele boy? Wrong crowd.
We're all like,
boy ukulele? No, the song's like massive on TikTok. TikTok.
What?
I just told you about it, all right? You watch when it's big, you know? I am cool. I am young and I am hip, okay?
Absolutely.
Yeah, anyway, so he's into ukulele boy, or boy okay. ukulele. It's basically, he plays my ukulele, favorite artist. This boy. I would probably have been into it if I was younger, yeah.
Okay. Does he listen to your music?
Sometimes.
Okay.
He likes Rolling in the Deep. One time I caught him in the back like this to hello. And I was like, he's got it.
Absolutely.
Yeah, he's got it.
Yeah, taste.
But no. But he does respect me now. It's nice.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Yeah, he should.
Yeah.
Okay. Another question? Right here? Yes. He's waving. Yeah.
We'll do one from around here in a sec. Don't you worry. I saw you.
Hi. Hi, Adele.
Hi.
First of all, I'm obsessed with Tom Waits. I would love he.
Oh, Mouth is my
to
favorite.
See, to hear you sing Green Grass.
Oh, lovely.
Because it's the best song for me ever writing.
Oh,
when
amazing.
He sing, like, as the trains go by, I start to cry. Like, I love so much the song. I'd love to hear you sing.
I love that you love
and
Tom
I have,
Waits.
I'm Brazilian. I'm sorry for my accent. I have a lot of great ideas for videos and song and albums for you that I brought for you here. And I'd like to give you.
I'll take it with me, of course. Sure. I won't read them here now, but of course I will. Look, that's a fold
that's
up.
There is a book there. That's not the reading. That's the experience for your life. You're not going to find the answer that you look for, but I'm sure you're going to know you're not alone in this life. She's amazing. She's Clarice Lispector. She's a Brazilian author.
Okay.
It's amazing. You are really huge in Brazil. You like Michael Jackson Brazil. You so like Michael Jackson Brazil. Can you imagine that? Yeah. So my question it is, what happened to the songs with Rafael Sadiq, Rick Nowitz,
wow, you,
Matt
you
Chandler, and John Legend?
With Rafael and who?
Rick Nowitz, Matt Chamberlain, and John Legend.
I never worked with John Legend.
Oh, okay.
The most I worked with John Legend, this venue actually, before it became the Flower Room, used to be Blind Dragon, which was a karaoke spot where I used to hold monthly karaoke parties. It was the night before my 30th, me and John did a cover of Ordinary People in Harmony. It was like around here, I think the stage was. That's the closest I've ever worked with him, so that was probably a tabloid rumour that heard that we were singing fan. And then we have a couple of mutual friends here in LA, so that's how we got linked together. Nothing. Sometimes when you go into sessions, we also chatted a lot and wasted a lot of time chatting. But, you know, there's actually lots of other people that I've worked with, and the songs have just never been right for the project I end up making. But 30, there were definitely, I'm trying to think, Jonathan, my manager, sorry. I'm trying to think, there was definitely more songs that didn't make it compared to 25 and 21 and stuff like that. But if they didn't make the album, there's a reason they didn't make the album. They weren't good enough.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for this amazing folder. And I will read it, and I'll definitely read that book. I love reading. Thank you.
Okay, yeah. Oh, God, don't make me pick, Adele. Don't do this. Don't make me do this. You right here. Yeah.
Hi. This is crazy. I have always loved the fact that you've had such a influence with jazz music. I grew up listening to like oldies and jazz music. It was part of the reason why I was drawn to you in the first place as a little girl. I just was curious to know like if you had a favorite like Ella Fitzgerald song or something like that. I've definitely have noticed your influence, especially with her too.
I love Ella Fitzgerald very, very much. Black Coffee is probably my favorite. Probably the Peggy Lee one as
love
well.
Peggy
yeah,
Lee.
I love, and I love Ella Fitzgerald, and I remember used to try like keep up with her scatting, boy.
Ooh,
that's an impossible task. But there's also a song by her that I love called Stone Cold Dead in the Market, which would definitely be banned these days. It's a duet, but she, yeah, that's probably one of my favourites. But Black Coffee is a song for sure. Maybe that's only because it's like the only one I can actually sing. I don't know, but it's...
You should try it one day.
Yeah. And then there's also, I mean, it's definitely more soul, but Aretha Franklin's cover of Muddy Waters is also amazing. I remember I did that once at the Brit School for a jazz assignment. Flopped, failed miserably. But but yeah, Black Coffee. Great question.
Thank you.
You look beautiful. You're really lovely.
Okay, we'll do another one back here. Okay. You right here? Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, you got similar sweaters on.
Hey, CableNet, let's go. Let's
love
do this.
It,
CableNet, hi. Oh, there's
hi,
even more back
hi,
there.
Darling.
I'm going to come to you next.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. You look so pretty tonight.
Oh, thank you. You look so dapper.
Oh, yeah. She helps.
Oh, nice. We look beautiful too.
Oh, she does.
She does.
This is Basmod. I'm Rakir.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Daydreamers turned it out.
Yeah.
Okay.
As you should. Okay, so you've dabbled in genres quite a bit, right?
I like to think so.
Yes, you have. I would like to believe so too. What genre that you haven't tackled yet would you like to hop into?
Rap. I actually can rap, yeah. I'm nasty as well when I rap. I'd give Whopper rap for his money,
go.
I'll tell you that. I like that.
Do you know, I do just love a piano. I just love a piano and my vocal. If you want anything new and exciting from me, it's just not going to happen. Middle of the road is taking up both lanes. That's what I say. Probably jazz. I definitely have dabbled in jazz, but maybe like some jazz standards or something like that could be really interesting to do, even if it's just for fun, that I never put out.
And I'm not sure if you saw, like, there was a rumor that you did a collab with Nicki Minaj once.
Oh, no. Never. I mean, I love her. Mm. I mean, I love her. I never saw that. That's so bizarre. That's never even nearly happened. I don't know how people think that.
I think after the monster, iconic monster video, Coffee Karaoke, everybody's like, you got to do it.
Oh, I think she's wonderful. I've always loved Nicki Minaj. She's a real vibe.
And just one more thing. Okay. Have you listened to Midnights yet?
I haven't, but I haven't. The only reason is because I've been in rehearsals for like 12 hours a fucking day. I'm sick and tired of anything musical. I think you're on the car.
Fair enough.
But I think Taylor's one of the greatest songwriters of our generation. So I will definitely give it a listen. I loved the two in COVID very, very much. And I think she's fun as well. She makes the release fun.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so I'm sure my son will probably make me listen to it.
Yeah, he's blasting it.
Probably. But I adore her, but I haven't yet. Have you? Do you enjoy it?
Yes. Nice. Yes. When you listen to it, let me know which one's your favorite.
All right, babes, I'll give you a call. I'll put it on the group chat. Yeah.
Of course. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, we'll do.
Let's right do there. A couple more, yeah.
Yeah. Right here.
Hi, Adele.
Hi.
I'm Sergio. Hi. I was actually reading my best friend's card, and it needs to be heard. So, like, I want him to tell you what he was going to ask you. But before I do pass the mic.
Okay.
I want to take a shot with you in the near future, hopefully, of tequila.
Oh, my God. We can't do it tonight. I might kill you.
Absolutely not tonight. But I was going to say, if you've ever been to Riverside, Mission Inn, they have the best tequila bar ever.
Do they?
Just FYI. Yes, ma'am.
Oh, all right. Let's do it. Let's do it.
I didn't get a ticket for your show because your fans, girl, they are aggressive. They're worse than Gaga fans. I'm not even kidding.
No way.
Yes. I lost my chance. Here I am today, though.
Well, here you are.
Here we are.
Here we are.
But I just love you so much, thank and I'm going to go ahead and pass it down to my best friend, Matt.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, mine was kind of long.
Okay.
And a little bit personal.
Oh, God. Here we go.
So I've been in an on and off relationship for about 10 years. While he does music. Does not want to get married until he, like, really, like, solidifies his goal in music. And I've been very respectful of it. I was wondering, if you have ever sacrificed a relationship, a love for your music? Because to him, his music is his first love.
I've only ever done the opposite. earlier, when I was younger, I used to... Now when I look back on it and I understand it more, they were threatened by the success that was almost pending for me, that I guess they could feel that I couldn't. And I would often be like, no, it's fine. I don't have to go on that fucking like 5-week American tour that sold out. Like this is on 19 and stuff like that. And until I realised what was actually happening, I definitely fell for that a few times. And the emotional turmoil of it would have an effect on my voice, which would make, you know, like, I really believe that your voice and your stomach really let you know when there's something wrong. For all of us, even if you're not a singer, like, you know, if you lose your voice and stuff like that, even if you're not using it every night in, like, a professional way, it seems to be one of the first things that goes along with your stomach. But I've definitely experienced a lot of musicians who behave like that, who that is their first love and stuff like that. Someone that I'm very close with can sometimes disappear for 3 weeks into the studio and not communicate with their partner. They seem to have an understanding. Someone I used to date was also a musician, and he'd also go off the radar. But at like 33 years old, that wasn't something that I could tolerate at all, because it didn't fit in with my plans and what I wanted to do. And I also used to be like, how does he not want to spend every single waking second with me? Like, you know? I used to be like, well, he's like a weirdo, like, you know.
Okay, freak.
But I personally have never done that. But I think if what he's trying to do doesn't align with what you're trying to do right now in your life, then maybe you just part for a little while. And both achieve your own things on your own and then come back together. Because what is meant for you will never leave you. I know we read that on Instagram every day, but it's true.
So, like, we have an apartment together in Orlando. Just so he gets away from him.
Yeah. Okay.
How long have you been together? 10 years, on and off?
10 years,
yeah. How old are you now?
It's about time. Yeah, I'm in 30s, 35.
But you love him?
Absolutely. That's my number one.
Yeah.
Forever. I'm all,
well, then maybe you answered it for yourself.
I've waited this long, so.
Yeah.
He's incredibly talented, and I believe.
There's also a chance it might not happen for him, though, and he has to come to terms with that on his own, which is going to be big as well, like, you know, for him. But as long as you can hold his hand through it.
Right. And I've learned to be here, like, to be on the side. Yeah. To be on the side and support.
As long as he's doing the same for you, though. Being on your side and supporting you in whatever you're trying to do.
Right.
Because if he's not, you've got to kick him to the curb. Where?
Adela's therapist is iconic. Look, every week, I'm just going to check in with you. Okay, we have one more, and I'm stressed. Someone's going to be mad at me. I'll do you. You're right here.
Actually, Adele, I have a question for you, but I want to say thank you so much. I thank you so much that you exist. You've done so much for so many people. You've touched everybody in this room. I've been a fan of yours for 15 years, and I just love you so, so deeply. Thank you for your music. Thank you for everything. Oh, thank you, darling. Thank you so much.
Thank you. You're my soulmate. Your shoes off already.
My high heels broke. Got out of my Uber. My high heels fucking broke.
Oh, and so we're shoes last barefoot. 5 minutes. You look amazing.
I love you, Adele. So I love you. I love you so much with all my heart. I truly do. Thank you.
Okay, that's kind of a perfect way to end. Oh. Yeah. On the emotion. Okay. Thank you all so much for coming. Thank you, Adele.
Really
I Drink Wine is incredible. Joe Talbot, amazing. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, babes. Thank you.
Thank you, Daydreamers.
Thank you, Daydreamers.
There we go.
Thanks for watching at home, Daydreamers. Yeah. There's a photo op for them, isn't there?
Yeah, there is a photo op.
I think it's around there.
It's around the bend there. It's I Drink Wine themed. We think of it all.
I think we did a good job, babes.
I think we really tore. We tore. That was sick. Okay, love you all. Adele.
That's Jen. Jen's worked with me since 19. She's from Sony.